sorry that I am not able to be with you for this celebration that marks the conclusion of the 60th anniversary year of Greensburg Central Catholic. I intended to celebrate this Mass with you, but as you know, I am now serving as the Bishop of the Diocese of Cleveland after having been appointed by Pope Francis. I would like to welcome the administration, faculty, staff, present families, alumni, and friends of Greensburg Central Catholic as we gather to celebrate a special Mass in thanksgiving for the school's 60 years of service to the young people and families of the diocese. Since 1959, Greensburg Central Catholic has been educating generations of centurions in a Catholic tradition of excellence that has prepared them to go out into the world to live faith-filled lives and to build careers that lead and inspire. This past school year marked a very special milestone in the history of Greensburg Central Catholic, 6 decades of staying true to its founding mission as a college preparatory school to promote the formation of students within a community of faith. Fulfilling the vision of the first bishop of the Diocese of Greensburg, Bishop Hugh L. Lamb, Greensburg Central Catholic High School began its story in 1958 when ground was broken for the school July 1st in an area of Hempfield Township known as Carbon. Construction of the new high school was completed and Central opened its doors to welcome its first freshman class on the feast of the Nativity of Our Blessed Mother, September 8, 1959. 6 different Catholic religious orders shared their areas of expertise as members of the first administration and faculty to serve at the new school. Greensburg Central Catholic was formally dedicated on November 29, 1959, by Bishop Lamb, who said, "It is my hope that the new high school will ever be a shrine of religion and a nursery of patriotism. It is my prayer that in the years to come, it will send forth into this community a large army of graduates who will bring honor to their alma mater, to their church, and to their country." There have been many changes at Greensburg Central Catholic these past 60 years, which have added to its proud history. However, the guiding principles and values of excellence, community, stewardship, and Catholic identity that Bishop Lamb was committed to in 1959 are the same ones that the school holds fast to today. Central's commitment to providing the best possible secondary Catholic education is just as strong today as it was then. The school community is blessed to have a strong alumni base. Our alumni are a visible credit to our school's success. Many of them are an integral part of our community as priests, religious sisters, teachers, coaches, administrators, parents, and grandparents of current students, volunteers, and benefactors. A key part of Greensburg Central Catholic's mission is to foster the formation of students in a community of faith that is centered on the teachings of the Catholic Church and incorporates the gospel values of Jesus Christ. Choosing the centurion as the school's official mascot, Central focuses on the charism of the centurion who professed the truth of Jesus Christ at the foot of the cross when he said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God." Catholic identity serves as the overarching guiding force for all of our Catholic schools. Everything we do and aspire to be should find its source from the wellspring of our Catholic identity. It should permeate the school's culture. In the words of Pope John Paul II, Catholic education is helping to form Christ in the lives of others. Our Catholic schools prepare students to relate Catholicism to the world around them where faith, culture, and life are harmonized, and the inalienable dignity of every human person is respected. The administration, faculty, staff, and students of Greensburg Central Catholic give witness to the way, the truth, and the life, who is Jesus, the Savior of the world. Today, we are immeasurably blessed as we come together at the table of our Lord for a special Mass that celebrates Greensburg Central Catholic's past with profound thanksgiving, its present with steadfast faith, and its future with enduring hope.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I want to begin by offering a welcome to all of those joining us throughout the Diocese of Greensburg and across our country, especially the alumni and alumni of Greensburg Central Catholic Junior Senior High School. We also are blessed to have with us former administrators, and welcome. It's great that you are here. Your presence is so important to us because you have played such a critical role in leading us forward during your time at GCC, which has brought us to where we are today. Each of your contributions has been important and a way for you to share with us the blessings that God has given you. We celebrate this Mass today as we conclude this 60th year that marks the opening of Greensburg Central Catholic. The anniversary day falls on September 8th, but due to the pandemic, this celebration has been pushed back. But finally, here we are to celebrate the conclusion of this year. As we enter into this celebration, we acknowledge God's infinite blessings. We offer this Mass in thanksgiving for our current community that is gathered here today and for all those members who are gathered and joining us virtually. Every time we gather to celebrate the Mass, we are always united. And so together in faith, let us begin this celebration as we acknowledge our sins and ask God for His forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nation into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel, is it my way that is unfair? Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life, since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed. He shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Compassion, O Lord, and your love are from of old. The sins of my youth and my frailties remember not. In your kindness remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Teaches the humble his way.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did the father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord. Growing up in the northern region of the Diocese of Greensburg in Armstrong County, I had the blessing of attending Divine Redeemer Elementary School from preschool until my sixth grade year. When I reached my final grade at Divine Redeemer, a decision had to be made as to where I would go for high school. I remember my parents briefly discussing the option of attending a Catholic high school. I heard them talking about a school in Greensburg. Now, as a sixth grade student, I remember thinking to myself when they were talking about this option, where is Greensburg? Growing up in the northern part of the diocese, this seemed so far away. I knew nothing about the school and had no interest in attending a place that I knew nothing about. Little did I know that 14 years later, God would get his way. On the day of my ordination, which took place here in Blessed Sacrament Cathedral, after Mass, I met with Bishop Brandt to receive my first assignment as a priest. I was so excited. The bishop informed me that I would serve as chaplain of Greensburg Central Catholic High School, and I remember thinking to myself once again, where is that school? I still had no idea. But later, I came to discover that this particular assignment was where God needed me to be. It was clear that God had a plan for me to be in this school, if not a student 14 years earlier, then at that point in my life as the chaplain. Today we mark 60 years of education provided by Greensburg Central Catholic. We acknowledge the dedication of our teachers, staff, our principals, administrators, religious sisters, our priests, our parents, grandparents, and also our students, who play such a critical role in the success of this prestigious institution. Every individual who becomes a member of GCC is there because God desires it. God desires every student, every teacher, every faculty member to be there for a reason. He desires us to be challenged in deepening our knowledge of our Christian faith. He desires us to be challenged in coming to explore the purpose of why he made us. He desires us to grow in mind, in body, and spirit in a way that honors the gift of our body, which he has given to us. And he desires us to grow and a deeper understanding of the love that he has for each of us. I have many stories that I could share thinking back over the past 7 years that express these desires that I have witnessed unfold in the life of our students. But there's one in my mind that stands out that I want to share with you. Several years ago, I was making my usual rounds through the cafeteria during lunch. I enjoy these moments, being able to walk around, to stop at a table, to see how the students are doing. On one particular day, I stopped at a table that had a majority of the soccer team present, and right beside them was the other members of the team. We had talked about the game they just had the night before, and after finishing talking about the success of that game, one of the players said to me, "Father, I have a question." Now, when a student prefaces their question with this warning, I always become slightly nervous, not knowing what's going to come. But then he went on to say, "Father, what is it like when you stand at the altar and you hold the bread in your hands and say the words that make it the body of Christ?" Now, that was not the question that I was expecting from this student in the cafeteria during a lunch period. I was surprised by the question that he asked, unprepared to give an answer. I don't remember what I said that day, and I'm sure my answer was not an answer that was worthy of the question that he had proposed. But I remember thinking later that day about this question. It just was on my mind. This is what makes a Catholic school, I thought to myself. It is by no mistake that I was there at that moment with that particular student who asked me such a profound question. It was a moment that deepened my faith, and I also hope that it deepened the faith of the student. These are the moments that God rejoices in when we respond to the opportunity to deepen our relationship with Him. For us who have been blessed to be a part of the history of GCC, please do not ever think that it was by accident that you found yourself standing among other centurions in this high school. You have become a member of this community because God has desired it. It was part of His plan. Jesus is always waiting for us to respond to His love and grow in a deeper relationship with Him. We must never forget this. Throughout His ministry, Jesus looked for these opportunities to teach His disciples and moments where He could transform their lives. He took advantage of every opportunity to help them reflect and implement the way that He was calling them to live. Why is this? Why did Jesus spend so much time going after so many who preferred to walk the other way? Because He was preparing them for life not just in this world, but the life to come. He was preparing them to get to heaven. He wanted them to be saints. As much as Jesus wanted this, the disciples were not always open to the Lord's invitation. They weren't always open to that conversion that He desired for them. It sounds a lot like us at times. Today in the gospel, we hear Jesus challenge the chief priests and the elders by telling them a story about two sons. The first son was asked by the father to go out and complete a task, to go out and work in the vineyard. The son flat out refuses his father's request. But later, he has a change of heart. The second son seems to say just what the father wants to hear, but has no intentions of following through with the words that he just spoke. The response of the first son seems to be disrespectful, but despite that harsh reply that first son offered, he is acknowledged as one who will share eternal life in the kingdom of God, along with the prostitutes and the tax collectors. It seems odd when we hear it, but it is this group that heard the word of God and allowed it to change their hearts. Christ has the power to do that. And so on this day, as we gather here for this very joyous celebration to recall the ministry that has taken place at GCC the past 60 years, as we look to the ministry that will continue to come in the years ahead, it is a time for us to reflect on the great work that has changed so many hearts of the students, their families, and even for us as faculty and administrators who are part of this community. So I want to invite you in the week ahead to take a moment to reflect on a few of these thoughts. Why did God call you to be a part of Greensburg Central Catholic? How has this community helped you discover your purpose in life? How have you come to know Christ as a centurion, and how do you live that out? Has your family been transformed by your Catholic education? And do you open yourself to being transformed even today for those who have graduated and moved on by the sacraments of our church? I often think back to that transformative experience I had at GCC in the cafeteria when asked such a profound question by one of our students. I can't say that I offered an adequate answer to this young man's question, but what I can say is that I have reflected over and over again in my prayer on that very question that was asked to me in the cafeteria by that young man. This question has been an ongoing source of reflection in my prayer and has deepened my devotion to the Eucharist and my own priesthood, often trying to come up with a good answer that was proposed to me by this student. reflecting on this moment, I have come to the conclusion that it was not the answer that maybe mattered to this young man. That wasn't important. But what was important, that it was where God needed both of us to be at that time, in that moment. And so remember, for all of those students who are at Greensburg Central Catholic today, you are where God needs you to be. For all of our graduates, think back to your time there. You were where God needed you to be as a centurion at GCC. After being there for 7 years, now starting my 8th year, I can finally say that I know where Greensburg Central Catholic is located. And I genuinely believe that God planned that a portion of my ministry would be spent in this assignment. It certainly has transformed my heart and brought me closer to Christ. May this Mass that we celebrate today be an acceptable offering to God in gratitude for 60 years of Catholic education. And may it also be a petition to God that He will continue to bless the Greensburg Central Catholic community as a place that transforms the hearts of so many believers. And so, as we say so often, as centurions, glory to God alone.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the 3rd day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. In gratitude for the countless blessings that God has given us, and for continued blessings upon our GCC community, let us now offer these prayers.
The response will be, glory to God alone. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for pastors, priests, and deacons within our diocese, that they may be blessed with zeal and courage, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For our civil leaders, that their life and laws reflect the values of our country, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For the graduates of Greensburg Central Catholic, living and deceased, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For our youth and young adults, that they may turn to Christ and the Church in their time of need, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For the people of our country who have suffered from fires, floods, and severe weather, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For young people who are discerning a call to the priesthood or religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For the sick, especially those suffering from COVID and their families and caretakers, that they may experience the gentleness of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone.
For those who will conclude their life's journey this day, we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God alone. Kind and merciful Father, who is slow to anger and rich in compassion, and who always provides for our needs, we ask that you hear these prayers that we have offered to you through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O merciful God, that this, our offering, may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessings may be laid open before us. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that, by sinning, we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose sufferings we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated.
As we ushered in the opening of the 2019-2020 school year, our school community began what was planned to be a year-long celebration of the proud 60-year tradition of Greensburg Central Catholic. No one would ever have imagined that in this milestone year for our school, the world would have to find ways to adjust to stay-at-home mandates, to learn new routines within the restrictions of social distancing, and for many, to continue the education of children while schools remain closed. If some good can emerge from this profound time of crisis and challenge created by the current coronavirus pandemic, it may lie in the awakening of our appreciation for the abundance of blessings that we enjoy each day and encourage us to live with a greater spirit of gratitude for what we have and for the presence of those whose love and support see us through life's darkest storms. Maybe we have come to appreciate that even in the presence of crisis and challenge, happiness can still prevail and give us hope. And that is why, in these unprecedented times that we now find ourselves, we can still rejoice in the celebration of Greensburg Central Catholic's 60-year tradition in the Diocese of Greensburg. In this same spirit of gratitude, on behalf of the administration of Greensburg Central Catholic, I'd like to offer my sincerest appreciation for the opportunity to celebrate the 60th year in the history of our school with such a beautiful Mass of Thanksgiving. I wish to express my deepest thanks to everyone involved in the planning of this liturgy, to everyone who participated, and to those near and far who offer their generous support for the mission of Greensburg Central Catholic. May we continue to look to the future of Greensburg Central Catholic with the promise of God's abundant blessings.
Thank you, Mr. Althoff, for those words, and to all of those who have joined us. So many people from so many different regions of this diocese and across really the United States. Thank you for being part of this celebration, joining us to be able to offer thanksgiving to God for the many blessings that he's given to this community. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Seek where you are found. Thy ideals and standards we shall teach the world. Since 1959, Greensburg Central Catholic has been educating generations of centurions in a tradition of excellence that has prepared them to go out into the world to live faith-filled lives and to build careers that lead and inspire. This past school year marked a very special milestone in the history of Greensburg Central Catholic as it celebrated 60 years of staying true to its founding mission as a college preparatory school to promote the formation of students within a community of faith. Fulfilling the vision of the first bishop of the Diocese of Greensburg, Bishop Hugh L. Lamb, Greensburg Central Catholic High School began its story in 1958. A site for the new school was chosen in an area of Hempfield Township known as Carbon, after the former Carbon Coal Mining Company, which had operated in the area from 1890 to 1916. The specific site that was chosen for construction of the new high school was the former Greensburg Carbon Airport. It had been built on land leased from the Rapaski family of Greensburg. By the fall of 1959, construction on the new high school was now complete and Central opened its doors to welcome the first freshman class on the Feast of Our Blessed Mother's Nativity, September 8, 1959. Selected to lead the school in its inaugural year as principal was Father Harry G. Hines. Father Hines served along with Father William Sheridan, the school's assistant principal. With an audience of 2,000, the school was formally dedicated on November 29, 1959, by Bishop Lamb along with David L. Lawrence, who had been elected in 1958 as the first Catholic to serve as governor of Pennsylvania. The campus of Greensburg Central Catholic has seen many changes in its 60-year history. One of the first occurred in 1962. Bishop Kinnear, the second bishop to serve the Diocese of Greensburg, proposed the construction of a faculty house to provide on-campus residency for the 6 groups of religious orders of sisters who taught at the school. In 2002, the building would be renovated to serve as the new performing arts center for the school, and shortly after, a beautiful new student chapel was created on the 3rd floor of the main school building. The campus saw further changes in 1967 with a new wing constructed to accommodate the growing enrollment and needs of the school's expanding curriculum. In 2007, an auxiliary gym was constructed to serve the growing number of men and women's sports. Since its first home game, Central had used Offutt Field in Greensburg for its football games. In 1989, the school constructed its own football stadium on campus in the area which had formerly been the practice field. In 1998, stadium lighting was installed to illuminate night football games and soccer matches. Changes to Greensburg Central Catholic did not limit themselves to physical structures on campus. When the 2011-2012 school year opened, Central became Greensburg Central Catholic Junior-Senior High School as it welcomed its first 7th and 8th grade classes to the student body. As technology is ever changing in our world, so is the changing classrooms of Greensburg Central Catholic. Today, students engage in a one-to-one computer program that allows each enrolled student to use an electronic device in order to access the internet and digital course materials. Innovative classroom techniques such as STEM and Makers Education programs empower students to work on projects, solve problems, think creatively, collaborate with peers, program bots, and invent new products that serve the school and the community. Catholic schools represent a shared dream to invest in something that makes a difference. These words can be found on the wall of the office of Dr. Maureen Marsteller, who became the superintendent for Catholic schools in the Diocese of Greensburg in 2014.
Hello, I'm Dr. Maureen Marsteller, and I'm the superintendent for Catholic schools for the Diocese of Greensburg. At Greensburg Central Catholic Junior Senior High School, we like to think that we share the dream of parents and guardians everywhere who want the very best for their children. We share the dream with the parents and guardians who recognize the critical importance of educating a child holistically. A Catholic education encompasses the physical, social, and intellectual pursuits of an outstanding education. Then it goes a step further by encompassing all of that education in a spiritual framework of moral and ethical guidance. This is what illuminates the path of the child toward a bright future. This is a future that brings them peace and uncertainty, calmness in turbulent times, and great joy in the prospect of everlasting life. Catholic schools make a difference by providing an education that truly lasts a lifetime. That is the dream we share with the parents and guardians at Greensburg Central Catholic Junior Senior High School. God bless.
Over the years, innovation and advancement have brought many new opportunities for students here at GCC, fostering partnerships with several institutes of higher education, including St. Vincent College, Seton Hill University, Mount Aloysius College, and the University of Pittsburgh. The school is able to offer a wide variety of college and high school classes that have helped students to earn enough college credits to place them in their second year of college.
Since the doors of Greensburg Central Catholic opened in 1959, the school's administration and faculty have been committed to providing students with the best academic opportunities that their high school experience can offer. Our faculty choose to teach here with the confidence that they are part of a community of educators who value excellence and innovation and that can thrive in a faith-filled environment. The college and high school program adds to the mission of Greensburg Central Catholic to promote the academic and spiritual formation of our students within a community of faith where we encourage our students to seek their personal best while contributing to the school's lasting tradition of excellence.
Greensburg Central Catholic has long been committed to helping students find enriching experiences that go beyond the classroom by offering a wide range of social, recreational, professional, spiritual, and leadership opportunities. The school presently hosts over 45 special interest groups, faith-based and service groups, academic honorary organizations, and youth fraternities and sororities. Each is led by students and supported by faculty or staff advisors. These experiences make the community of administration, faculty, staff, and students who call this place home truly something special.
Hello, my name is Mary Jo Brecht, and the course of my entire career, all 42 years of it, have been at GCC. And throughout those years, I've always made a point to work with student activities. It's what I love, it energizes me, whether it's taking sophomores to Cedar Point or planning student activities like the Christmas dance. I really enjoy them. And as I enjoy them, I also know that students enjoy them and they also discover more about their own gifts and talents when they plan and implement a freshman field day or create the skit for their spirit week or plan a mission carnival. And it adds another layer of growth to the young men and women they will become.
Hello, I'm Ashley McWilliams, a 2020 graduate of Greensburg Central Catholic. During my time serving as student body president, I got a unique perspective of how students give back in many different ways. Whether it would be a group going to serve the less fortunate at a food bank, or sharing smiles with those who have special needs, there is a sense of pride knowing that we are the hands and the heart of Jesus.
Since 1963, when the first class to enroll as freshmen graduated from Greensburg Central Catholic, the school's athletic programs have greatly grown. The traditional mainstay sports of football, basketball, track, and baseball were the ones to make their initial debut with the opening of the school. Today, students at Greensburg Central may select from 22 interscholastic varsity sports that compete in Western Pennsylvania's Interscholastic Athletic Association.
Hi, my name is John Sullivan. I'm a teacher at Greensburg Central Catholic High School. I've been teaching at Central since 1974. I coached football for about 35 years, and I was the athletic director for 15 years. During those 46 years that I have been at Central, I have seen some fantastic athletes and some amazing teams perform for the maroon and silver. Central has produced many, many section championships, at least 10 WPIAL championships, and about 8 state championships. This has been accomplished in both boys and girls sports. Also, several individuals have captured WPIAL championships as well as state championships. GCC has also had graduates play professionally and even compete for the U.S. Olympic team. As far as the classroom is concerned, Central athletes have to produce. Their academic success is quite evident because so many of our student athletes go on to compete at the collegiate level. GCC has been represented on many Division I athletic teams, including the very prestigious Ivy League as well as the service academies. Plus, many go on to play at Division II and Division III schools. That speaks volumes for the success of GCC athletes and its academics.
The school's fine arts programs have grown over the years as well. Today, Central offers 29 different courses that span the spectrum of visual and performing arts. Fall dramatic productions, the spring musicals, choral concerts, and art shows have become part of the Central tradition.
Hello, my name is Erin Tiedemann, and I am the department chair for the Visual and Performing Arts Department at Greensburg Central Catholic High School. The Visual and Performing Arts Department at Greensburg Central Catholic offers a comprehensive program in the arts for all students. Students in the arts at GCC strengthen their critical thinking skills, build confidence, and learn to problem solve. Being involved in productions at GCC helps students to develop poise and leadership skills and to work as a part of a team.
Greensburg Central Catholic is blessed to have strong foundations of alumni that span six decades of faith-centered education. As the pride of Greensburg Central Catholic, our alumni are a credit to our school's success, and many are an integral part of our community as teachers, coaches, administrators, parents, volunteers, and benefactors.
Hello, I'm Dr. Greg Bisignani, and I'm a very proud graduate of Greensburg Central Catholic class of 1985. And I can say without any hesitation, doubt, and with 100% certainty that I wouldn't be the person I am today. I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing today if it wasn't for the foundations that were set in me when I was a student at Greensburg Central Catholic 35 years ago. Greensburg Central Catholic was able to instill in me the values and virtues, give me the basis to form my social, academic, spiritual, and emotional foundation to be able to succeed in this world today. And I'm so thankful to be a graduate of Greensburg Central Catholic. I've been the president of the Alumni Association for Greensburg Central Catholic for the last 7 or 8 years. And it's such an easy job because the graduates and alumni just make the honor me, honor the school, and it's what makes our school is our alumni.
Most important to Greensburg Central Catholic's purpose, inception, and its continued existence is to foster the formation of students within a community of faith that is centered on the teachings of the Catholic Church and incorporating the gospel values of Jesus Christ. Choosing the centurion as the school's official mascot, Central focuses on the charism of the centurion who professed the truth of Jesus Christ at the foot of the cross. As a community of faith, our school has been committed to helping students live the harmony between our gospel values and our daily conduct.
My name is Father Bandura. I serve as the chaplain of Greensburg Central Catholic High School. I began as chaplain at GCC in 2013. Anyone who enters into the GCC community quickly learns that the centurion is our mascot. And it was the centurion who demonstrates this great conversion in his life of going from only knowing about Jesus to knowing Christ in his heart, being able to proclaim that truly this is the Son of God as he stands at the foot of the cross. That's the mission for all of our students. And it's also the mission for our faculty and administrators each day to proclaim this truth in how we live, in the way that we treat ourselves, and in the way that we serve the community, to make sure that Christ is the center.
Shining ever brightly as a shrine of religion and a nursery of patriotism, the tradition of Greensburg Central Catholic has entered its 60th year. The school has proven to be a lasting legacy of its founder, Bishop Hugh Lamb. Greensburg Central Catholic remains committed to upholding the words of Bishop Lamb's motto, Soli Deo Gloria, glory to God alone. Today and always.